Is local AI image generation already obsolete? Do we even need tools like ComfyUI, Automatic 1111 or local models like Flux, Stable Diffusion 3.5, PixArt or HiDream anymore? Today we have image generation directly integrated into large language models like Google Gemini with ImageGen 4, XAI Grok, Microsoft Copilot, Image Creator and, of course, GPT-4o image generation. These tools promise comparable functionality and image quality, but without the need to install anything, without complex workflows and without understanding all the details behind local setups. But is that actually true? In this video, we'll take a closer look and separate facts from wishful thinking. Before we look at the actual models and tools, let's quickly define what really matters when generating images. Of course, it's about quality, but also about speed, costs, and the hardware you need to run these models. Then there's control. How much influence do I have on the output? Can I actually steer the image generation in a way that I get what I want and not just something that looks nice but wasn't really my idea? Privacy can also be important, depending on what I'm generating and where I'm generating the images. And then there are a few technical aspects. Can I freely define the aspect ratio? Can I upscale to higher resolutions? Can I embed text into image correctly? Can I easily change styles, adapt existing images, or fully redesign content? And finally, for some users, the question whether there are filters, restrictions, or censorship applied to certain topics or content. Let's start with local models and tools. These are systems you run fully on your own hardware. You pay once for your machine, but there are no monthly subscriptions. You fully own your data, you control every step, and there are no content filters. For these tests, I'm using the Shuttle 3 model. It delivers flux level image quality, generates very fast, and since it's Apache 2 licensed, it's legally simple to use even in commercial projects. You'll find all links to the tools and models in the description. Now let's look at a few typical local workflows, all based on our starting image. A cat wearing armor, standing in front of a sunny lake. First, we replace the cat with a dog. That's a typical inpainting task. Then we add sunglasses to the dog, again modifying just a small area. Next, we place some custom text onto the shield. This is also done with inpainting, but shows how flexible text integration can be locally. And finally, we use ControlNet depth to change the entire scene while keeping the basic composition. For example, turning the image into a Dragon Warrior version. These are just a few examples of what local workflows allow you to do, and in a moment, we'll see how integrated LLM-based tools compare. If you've enjoyed the video so far and want to see more content like this, hit the subscribe button and ring the bell. Now let's move on to the integrated image generation inside large language models. First, a quick overview of where we are right now. ChatGPT-4o with integrated image generation. This is currently the most advanced version and works directly inside ChatGPT. Microsoft Copilot's Image Creator. As of May 2025, it officially uses ChatGPT-4o image generation, not DALL-E 3, meaning the same quality ChatGPT users get, and it's free for anyone with a Microsoft account, usually with daily limits. Google Gemini, depending on where you use it, some versions still use ImageGen 3, others already ImageGen 4. In my tests, I was likely still working with ImageGen 3. Grok 2 from XAI, image generation here runs on a Flux-based backend. The key idea behind these LLM-based tools is very simple. You describe what you want and that's it. Because these models are originally trained on text, they're very strong in understanding and interpreting natural language prompts, often even quite complex ones. Unlike local tools, you usually don't need to mask areas or define exact positions. Very often, a simple text instruction is enough to add, replace, or modify elements. However, and this is based on my personal experience in these tests, every modification always leads to a complete new generation. Even when some tools offer masking options, the entire image still changes at least slightly. So as before, let's run through the tasks again, but now with the integrated LLM-based tools. The basic generation with our initial prompt works fine with all of them, no surprise here. Replacing the cat with the dog? Again, all models handled that very well, just by using simple text instructions. Adding sunglasses? Same story, no problems across any of the systems. Placing text onto the shield works with all models, which is not surprising since text is actually one of their core strengths. For outpainting, in this case we want to extend the image above and below, some models support it by changing the aspect ratio. Grok does not support this currently. Style transfer is where things start to differ. Using a visual style I demonstrated in one of my earlier Flux videos inspired by Shinji Aramaki, only ChatGPT and Microsoft Copilot could successfully apply that style here. Although both deliver a bit different results. Gemini and Grok struggled here. Composition control also shows interesting differences. First, I tried simulating ControlNet's canny approach. I converted an image into a simple edge drawing and used that as a guidance input while maintaining the original style. This worked with ChatGPT, but there is an easier way. While local models often require tools like ControlNet to preserve the layout, LLM models can handle it directly via the prompt. Simply saying keep the composition worked quite well. Only with Gemini it didn't work, but I expect this to change in the future. When it comes to upscaling, ChatGPT and Copilot both support generating images in their maximum integrated 2 resolution and can also upscale existing images even if they were originally generated by local tools or by Grok. Gemini and Grok didn't offer upscaling in my tests. Anyhow, these upscaling processes always involve a full regeneration, which means the image will slightly change with every upscale. So where does this leave us? With LLM-based image generation, you can now do, let's be honest, almost everything. The image quality is surprisingly high and it's very unlikely this will suddenly reverse. Quite the opposite. It will only get better from here. These tools are easy to use. Most things happen directly through text prompts and even non-technical users can get great results very quickly. Many of the typical local workflows are now covered. In some cases, they're even faster. For example, compared to complex high-res workflows with ControlNet. Style adjustments often work quite well too. And of course, you don't need expensive local hardware anymore. But, and that's important, every time you modify something, the image is fully regenerated. For professional users who want exact pixel-level control, that can be a limitation. Resolutions are typically fixed. Aspect ratios are often limited or need workarounds. Locally, you can work with many different models and of course LoRAs, which brings far more visual variety. Not everything looks like ChatGPT or Copilot, you get more creative diversity. Also, local models can run fully unattended. Need 50 variations of the same concept? You can queue your jobs overnight with no waiting time or API limits in case you use the tools via API, which is another story. And finally, there are still content filters and privacy considerations which simply don't exist in local workflows. That's why professional users will often continue to use local AI image generation or combine both worlds depending on the task. For hobbyists and many semi-professional users, LLM-based tools may already be good enough for most of their work. But what do you think? Leave your thoughts in the comments and if you don't have a keyboard nearby, just leave a like.